here on BBC One Comedy and the first of a new series of the Ronnie Corbett Special.
Hello and welcome to the BBC Television Theatre, where we're all ready to get your Easter weekend off to a flying start with an absolutely smashing lineup of guests. Joining me here in the show tonight are the Immaculate King Singers, followed by a barbershop quartet who will be performing Harmony Hairsprays. And we'll also be meeting the exciting and vivacious Rita Hunter and my old mate Jimmy Tarbuck. So please sit back and enjoy the entertainment, which begins as always with our fabulous dance team, Jeff Richards, First Edition.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the world of opera, Miss Rita Hunter. It just seemed appropriate somehow, you know, because I've always been a fan of Noel Coward's, and I thought, well...
Ivor Novello.
Huh?
Ivor Novello.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry, have you? I didn't really...
No, I mean the song. It was written by Ivor Novello.
Oh, yes, that. Oh, I knew that. Yes, I did know that. When I said Noel Coward, you know, I didn't mean that Noel Coward. I meant, the other one.
The other one?
The one who called himself Ivor Novello. You know, the one who wrote Rosemary.
Oh, that was Frimmel.
Yes, I thought so too. I didn't like it. I was referring, of course, to, Hansel and Gretel.
Oh, Humperdinck.
Pardon?
Humperdinck.
Well, I'll get you a glass of water. There's
no
need to be...
No. The opera. The opera was written by Humperdinck.
Oh, yeah. Well, Rita, as you get to know me, you'll realize there are two things closest to my heart. One is the ground, of course. And the other is opera.
Ah, now which school do you prefer, Ronnie?
Well, I preferred St. Peregrine's Primary, really. I was very happy. I started taking in boys.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, did you see me in Götterdämmerung last July?
No, I went to Budley Salter in August.
Oh, now, Ronnie, why don't you admit about opera?
I don't know the first thing about opera. I'll have you know, I played washboard for Joan Sutherland. Until it fell on me. So we're going to listen to you sing right now, isn't that correct?
That's right. Yes.
So why don't you go and change into your opera togs, and I will change into a sort of version of Richard Baker.
Oh, shorter version. Sure.
See you later. Ladies and gentlemen, Rita Hunter.
Welcome to the Star of Sweden, where you join us in time for scene 22, act 9 of that great opera by Lasagna Verdi, I solo mio degli cascare, The Loneliness of the Long-Distance Runner. The opera tells the story of Renata, a lovely gypsy girl, daughter of the drunken bearded Pistachio. One morning she meets and marries Commander Plankton of the U.S. Navy in the beautiful duet Ciao Ciao Capitano, of Hello Sailor. Renata remains faithful to Plankton and even more faithful to an entire regiment of Alpine Irregulars. As the act begins, we see Alessandra seated in the courtyard, cozily fanning her tutti. She is the half-daughter of her half-father, Semi-Detaccio, and after a quarrel she threatens to die of consumption. Semi-Detaccio, mad with rage and foolishly disguised as Nicholas Barton, attempts to climb over the parapet but is caught by the Cavalieri. In a touching farewell scene, he is hung, drawn, and quartered. His body, now in four pieces, just manages to sing in quadraphonic sound the wonderful aria, Ouch, Nupi, Nalgo, Nutsup. Unfortunately, Miss Lino Zavaroni has a cold tonight, so the part of Flight Lieutenant Milbrace will be sung by the pipes and drums of Security Corps. His only option now is Renata, left to starve to death in the Doge's dungeons, is secretly fed by her past lovers, and is soon imprisoned in the Leaning Tower of Pizza. Totally without legal aid, she awaits the arrival of almost anybody.
And glamorous, and dreamy.